I would like to talk today about the stochastic Conway game of life. We have to start with what the classic Conway game of life is. It is a cellular automaton devised by British mathematician John Conway. The game takes place on an infinite board, although you can of course use a finite size of board due to limitations. The board consists of cells that can be in one of two states. The cell can be alive or can be dead. Most often living cells are marked with a color, and the game takes place in runs, cycles, or generations. And in each such cycle, the rules of the game are checked for each cell on the board. There are three main rules. The first is about living cells and says that if a live cell has two or three neighbors, that cell stays alive. In other words, it survives. Another rule describes the behavior of a dead cell, which with a certain number of neighbors, in the classical version this number is three, the dead cell comes alive, so it changes its state from dead to life. The last rule applies to all other cells that either die or remain dead. The rules defined in this way allow for the construction of various types of structures. The first are unstable structures that change in successive cycles, but do not return to their initial state. Next, we have still lives that are structures that look the same in the next generations. They never changing their shape. An example is the square closest to the center of the board, and that structure is called a block. Oscillators are structures in which the cells that compose them change in the next cycles. What different them from unstable structures is that they return to their original shape after certain number of cycles. Oscillators change periodically, and the simplest such structure is a blinker, which is made up of three cells arranged in a row. And it can be seen on the left of the board. It does not say that structures cannot move. Spaceships travel across the board, and one of the simplest examples of this is a glider that can be observed also on the screen. We can connect these structures with each other. The GANs consist of an oscillator that ejects or maybe shoots a spaceship from time to time. And the most spectacular videos of the Conway game of life in action consists of numerous GANs firing all over the map at other structures. The classical Conway game of life is too perfect, too ideal, I could say unheard of in nature. In order to make this game more real, we need to add some kind of probability. The stochastic Conway game of life has three main rules. A live cell that has two or three neighbors may, but not has to, survive. We draw a number for each cell between 0 and 100 and compare it to the predetermined probability. It is similar with a dead cell. If it has three neighbors, it can come back to life with a given probability. But if we were to repeat the measurements for a given structure many times, the final result would not be always the same. Any other cell that has at least one neighbor has a certain probability to change its state to be alive or to be dead. In this rule, there is an obligation to have at least one neighbor to prevent live cells from forming in places where there are no living cells, as this would cause some kind of chaos. Cells would appear in random places and then disappear in the next cycle. So, having such defined rules, we are able to carry out some measurements. Note that in the stochastic Conway game of life, the steel structures are not steel. The oscillators stop returning to their initial shapes. This gives us the opportunity to measure several things. First, we need to establish what we consider to be the death of the population. Death of the population is a situation where there are no living cells on the board, okay? The terms of the population, therefore, the initial structure, together with modifications in the next cycles, can be tested in terms of the life expectancy of the population. We can measure when population have died. If the population have died around average, or maybe there is a widespread, we can check which cells were alive or dead for how long. All done measurements were made on a 10 by 10 board with the initial block structure in the center. The graphs show the life expectancy of the population for specific probability levels. And the horizontal axis, shows the next attempts, and the vertical axis shows the cycle in which the given attempt population died. We can see the means for the probabilities of 99.5% and 99%. This is this line and this. And we can observe higher values for the left plot. And there the life expectancy was about 50 cycles, where for 99% probability, it was 37 cycles. Below this probability, the life expectancy of the population increases. And when it is low enough, the population never dies. Therefore, I had to specify the maximum cycle at which the program must exit. And I have set this limit at a cycle equal to 1000. Now we can show the population life average for different probabilities in one graph. For a probability of 100, the population, of course, never dies, because this is an example of the classic Conway game of life. And we tested a square, which is a steel structure. As the probability decreases, the life expectancy of the population decreases. And from around 98%, the average life expectancy of the population begins to rise. Below 85%, the population practically never dies. An interesting question is how often populations died in specific cycles. For example, for a probability of 99% and the life expectancy around the 40th cycle, populations most often died before the 30th cycle. Only a few living populations survived to the 100th or 200th cycle. Now that we know what the average life of the population is, let's check how often which cells lived on the board. The X and Y axis of the graphs show the position of the cells on the board. And the vertical axis shows the life expectancy ranges from 0 to 1, where a value of 0 means that the cell was dead in any cycle, so it was always dead. And a value of 1 means that the cell was alive in each cycle. For 100% of probability, the graph, of course, does not change in the next cycles because the square is a still structure. But things get more interesting for smaller probabilities. In the next cycles, we can observe the short lifespan of the population, but also moments when dead cells near to the initial structure come to life. For probabilities of around 50%, the rules of the game play less and less of a role. Charts are getting flatter, and in this one situation, a probability of 0% results in cell negation. This means that a living cell will surely die, and a dead cell will surely come to life. The stairs that we can observe in the first cycles are the result of this. With the next cycles, cell density, that is the time a cell has been alive, approaches 50% for smaller probabilities. Until then, we tested the square structure, but we can have other shapes. For example, the shape of the form X and the graphs will be like this. This is there are symmetric shapes of the graphs, and more shapes like that is, for example, this cycle. And the graphs be like that. But what when we put two squares, for example? No. The graphs started more to be more interesting, but the borders are closed, so what can we see when I open, for example, upper board and left board for this shape? The symmetric is not is not this perfect, yeah? At the end, I will add what else can be added to the Conway game of life. To make it more like the world around us, cells do not have to be either alive or dead. they can live with a certain amount of life. And in that case, we have to change the rules again, because such a cell will almost never have exactly two or three neighbors. We need to set a certain range, for example, from 2¾ of a neighbor to 3¼ of a neighbor. This gives us the possibility to further measurements, and it in no way limits us to further modifying the rules and the program. Thank you.
Now the questions.
So thank you.
No questions.
I don't know if I have questions.
We don't have any on the chat.
Okay, I think this was definitely interesting, you know, with respect to what we were saying just minutes before, because we you see how it is possible to engineer emerging behaviors. And also, I think you see how probability can play a role. Of course, also Conway Game of Life is a great simplification of what we have around us, but I think it gives an idea. So now I think it's time to prepare for the, if there are no questions, but I can see. I'm sure that also Darius will be and this group, people and Chris and people from Greco will be happy to answer offline to your questions or doubts or remarks.